Good afternoon, and good afternoon. Happy Thursday, everyone. Hope you're having a great Thursday afternoon. Temperatures today down a few notches, thanks to the extra cloud cover. But it has been mainly dry thus far. I don't think it stays that way for everyone this evening. I think it's going to be location dependent as to who may see a little bit of rain and who will not. And I'll show you radar in just a moment and let you know who's going to see what and where. And we'll talk about the weekend as well and the latest on tropical storm. Got to say this right. Isaias. That's a tough one. I got to keep reminding myself. It doesn't, once you get it, it rolls off the tongue, but you just have to remember to say it the same way every time. I'll talk about that in just a moment. Welcome to Whiteboard Weather. Thanks for spending a little part of your Thursday afternoon with me to get a simply accurate, no hype outlook, and we are the best in the burg. You know that already. So we'll get to those details of the weather and a little bit more in just a moment. First, how about we head over and check out our Thursday afternoon sponsor. They are Wetgo at GetGo, and they are offering unlimited washes for one low monthly price. They call it Wetgo Unlimited. You've heard me talk about it. Now is the time to act upon it. Unlimited washes, really exactly what it states it is. You can get as many washes as you want for one low monthly price, available at all 40 plus Wetgo locations across the region. No contract is required. You're not locked in for anything more than month to month. You can pick from four different plans. They start as low as $14.99 a month. And when you get Wetgo Unlimited now through August the 4th, let me say that again, through August the 4th, when you buy your first month, you get your second absolutely free. That means if you do the $14.99 plan, you get two full months of unlimited washes for just $14.99. You can't go through the car wash twice for much less than $14.99. So it really does pay for itself and then some in as little as 2 days. It is Wetgo at GetGo Unlimited. Check it out and be sure to make yourself eligible to win the Great Car Wash Giveaway. You have one more day to get eligible for week number 4. Get in your photo, tag a friend. You'll be eligible to win week 4 and possibly unlimited car washes for an entire year. You heard me, 1 year, unlimited car washes. All right, let's check out the current conditions across the area. Right now, as I said, temperatures upper 70s and low 80s. Newcastle 79, you got Butler at 81, 82 in Pittsburgh, 84 in Latrobe, and 82 in Washington. We've seen clouds and intermittent sunshine. It's been in and out of the clouds throughout the day today, but we've leaned more toward clouds for the most part. Dew points, depending on where you are, a little bit different. Dew point values a little less as you get further north. You can see Meadville's at 64, but the dew point value in Indiana is at 70. So we are and have been ingesting more atmospheric moisture. As a result, it's become muggier and will stay that way for the next several days. A quick look at radar. As I mentioned, the opportunity to see some rain showers likely going to be location dependent. As of a little after 3 o'clock this afternoon, you can see a little bit of moisture streaking in across parts of Ohio, but it looks like it's primarily focused from Pittsburgh on south. You can see showers along I-70 and generally moving west to east. So the best rain shower chance, it would appear, the rest of this afternoon and this evening would be from Pittsburgh on south. It doesn't look like it's going to be a tremendous amount of rain, but enough that will dampen things up, probably give you a little bit of water for your garden or your lawn. As you get further north, it looks like the chances are going to be much less to see any rain the rest of today and into this evening, but there will be other opportunities to see rain over the weekend. A quick breakdown of the surface map, and I'll try and explain this to you as best I can, as simple as I can. You'll notice south of Pittsburgh, there is what we call a stationary front. It's the blue triangles meeting up with the red semicircles. That boundary is going to be the highway for a few disturbances between now and early in the day on Saturday. So it looks like the best opportunity for rain showers, again this evening, will be south. Friday morning, you can see that boundary does sink a little further south. So again, I think the best chance of seeing a shower tomorrow is going to be from Morgantown south. And likewise, early in the day on Saturday, this is Saturday morning, I do expect by Saturday afternoon, this whole boundary mess is going to start lifting back north, which is going to put us in a zone that has a greater opportunity to see more numerous rain showers. So I think the next couple of days, anything's going to be spotty, but showers will become more numerous, more widespread, more commonplace by late Saturday into Saturday night and Sunday. And as we're at the computer, let me show you the latest on Tropical Storm Isaias. That's the correct pronunciation. Look it up. I checked it multiple times. Right now, still forecast by the National Hurricane Center to stay a tropical storm, and the track has shifted a little further east. Right now, at least the center of the cone of uncertainty, which is what you call that sort of shaded area, the center of it keeps the storm just offshore of the east coast of Florida. Saturday morning could be just offshore Miami, Fort Lauderdale, or say Saturday evening. Sunday morning, a little further north, maybe up closer toward, what would that be, Daytona Beach, and then a hard right turn, and perhaps off the coast of the Outer Banks, Monday night into Tuesday morning of next week. Now, I do have a minor concern at this point, even though it's not showing up here. As the storm maybe becomes a little better organized, it's going to hit some very warm water here in the Gulf Stream. So I am concerned somewhat about maybe some additional intensification. It could become a Cat 1 hurricane as it reaches just north of the Bahamas in this vicinity. Something to watch over the course of the next couple of days. And I will continue to track Isaias for you as we head into and through the upcoming weekend. Jacqueline checking in from, or I should say asking about her family in Tampa. They're on the other side of the state, so Jacqueline, they'll be just fine. And even the folks on the east side of Florida, quite honestly, if it stays at tropical storm strength, you're going to get rain and some stiff winds, but nothing too terribly destructive. So it would be, and it's moving fast enough that it's not going to linger for any length of time, so that cuts down on the impacts somewhat as well. But something, of course, to watch carefully over the course of the next couple of days. Let's hit up some birthdays very quickly before we get over to the whiteboard. Interesting. I just found this out late this morning, early this afternoon. Pittsburgh Pirate manager Derek Shelton, the current manager, he's 50 today. And the manager before him was Clint Hurdle. Clint Hurdle also has a birthday today. He's 63. So the last two Pirate managers, both celebrating birthdays on this day, the current one and the one that preceded him. Arnold Schwarzenegger, happy birthday, as well as Terry Crews, Lawrence Fishburne, Hilary Swank, the actress, Lisa Kudrow, the actress from Friends fame, and Henry Ford, who was one of the pioneers of the automotive industry, had his birthday on this day. It's National Chili Dog Day today, National Intern Day today, National Cheesecake, and a shout out to my father-in-law, David Basher. It is National Father-in-Law Day today. He's not only a great father-in-law, but a great guy. So shout out to my father-in-law. All right, let's get over to the whiteboard, breaking it down for you for today. And again, we're brought to you by WhetGo. At GetGo, check out the WhetGo Unlimited program. Between now and August the 4th, when you sign up, No contract required, and you get your second month absolutely free for one low price. That's 2 months worth of car washes for as little as $14.99. Unlimited means unlimited. Sunset tonight, 8:37. Sunrise tomorrow morning, 6:15. Moon is waxing gibbous. Tropical storm Isaias, that's how you say it, track near the east coast of Florida through this weekend, Saturday and Sunday. And for Pittsburgh, the July rainfall total thus far, 3.10 inches, which is a deficit of 0.49 inches for the month. And we still have one more day to make up some of that deficit. Tonight, 64. Again, that evening shower chance looks to be the greatest from Pittsburgh south. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Tomorrow, 83 degrees. Clouds win out over sunshine. Most places stay dry tomorrow. As you get closer to Morgantown, slightly better chance you could see a shower tomorrow. And then tomorrow night, patchy clouds, mild, 65 degrees. On Saturday, partly sunny skies. I think it's dry in the morning. I think it's dry at midday and early afternoon. And I think the shower chance will increase the second half of the afternoon. So later in the day on Saturday, 82 degrees. And then from Saturday night into early next week, it's an unsettled weather pattern, which means we'll have a daily threat of some scattered showers on Sunday, 82 degrees. That doesn't mean it's going to rain all day, but it does mean we'll be dodging rain showers for a good chunk of the day. On Sunday, same setup Monday, 81 degrees, humid with scattered showers, and you guessed it, 82 on Tuesday with a few showers. So in many aspects, it is the 180 degree turn from what it has been, which has been hot and dry. Temperatures will be more seasonal, and it's going to be a little more unsettled late in the weekend and early next week. So that is a look at your Thursday afternoon whiteboard from WhetGo at GetGo. Diana asked, did it rain in Waynesburg yesterday for rain day? The answer is no, it did not. But they still had their celebration. Most of it was virtual, but they did not add rain for their rain day celebration this year. So there you go. That's what I have for you. We covered a lot of ground today, talked about a lot of things. Your weekend weather, tropical system that I'm watching. I like when there's a lot of things to talk about. And it gives me more opportunities to educate you on the ways of weather and meteorology and why things sometimes work the way that they do. So it's good stuff. Thank you for spending a little part of your Thursday afternoon with me. As always, I appreciate it. I ask that you do me a solid and please share Whiteboard Weather with your Facebook friends. The more you share, the more people become aware and they can tune in Monday through Friday, 7:30 and 3 o'clock. A couple of additional notes. Tomorrow, obviously, is Friday, which means Friday morning funnies. The best, worst dad jokes you're going to hear of the week. Start your Friday morning with a chuckle. And of course, we will have our Friday afternoon tiebreaker tomorrow. You get a chance to vote and potentially select which tie I wear on TV this weekend. But my TV schedule this weekend is a little different, just FYI. I will not be on Saturday and Sunday night on WTAE. I just have one slot this weekend. I'll be on Saturday morning. So when you wake up first thing Saturday morning, you can click it on and you can see yours truly Saturday morning. I think the times are 5 to 7 a.m. I'm going to be up early. And then there's a break and then 8 to 10 a.m. So those are the time slots I'll be on Saturday morning on WTAE. But we'll do the tie thing tomorrow. And it will be Pittsburgh Penguin related. So that's my theme heading into Saturday because it is the start of the Penguins run to the Stanley Cup. I'm going to be optimistic. All right, that's going to do it for today. Hey, thanks for the stars. Saw a bunch coming in today. Can't thank you enough. Really appreciate it. Have yourself a great rest of this Thursday, everyone. And I'll see you bright and early tomorrow morning at 7:30 a.m. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Peace.
Have a great one.